So, there's something wrong with the role recruits. Let's break down why.
It's an orange juice.
The design of this card was based on adding dual lane split type decks and to help with defending against the existing three musketeer split deck without being vulnerable to spells. The Royal Recruits were intended to be easy to use and simple to play as a common card. Because this card shares so many similarities with the Guards and the Dark Prince, I would have assumed that it would be an epic card. The Royal Recruits will be nerfed pretty soon. Because the Clash Royale League is coming out, they don't want to have brand new cards that overpower the existing cards that dominate other decks and want a fair and equal opportunity with every card, so expect a nerf the first Monday of August. To summarize what Supercell said went wrong with the Royal Recruits, both the first and second points mention health, so we can expect a nerf to their health somehow. The last point mentions Rumham's biggest regret is reducing their elixir cost from 7 to 6, so it's very likely that they will be reverting the cost of the card back to its intended 7 elixir cost. In summary, the current Royal Recruits are just as broken, if not even more broken, than when the Rascals and the Night Witch were released. So we can expect some nerfs to the health and elixir cost. Maybe not the deployment just yet, so we'll hold off on that. I personally love how Seth and the balancing team are very transparent with their reasonings, how they make the cards, and their method of releasing new cards to Clash Royale. Big props to them in acknowledging the issue and for the quick response to the community. They're a low skill cap card. Why is this? Because there are only so many positions you can place them, and almost anywhere you place them is not wrong. It's an overpowered card in the game due to the lack of placement position choices. This is just the placement. You either place it in the very back, place it in the middle, in front of the Princess Tower, or in the front of the bridge. It almost requires no thinking. If you play it all the way in the back, it's as safe as playing three Elixir Archers in the left lane, because now your opponent can't attack either lane because they move so slowly, protecting both sides. Even though you committed 6 Elixir, it's a very safe play. Another issue with this card is that they have unreasonably high health for a card that doesn't even feel like a swarm, even though it kind of is. If you look at Zappies, for example, those three Zappies combined have a total of 1,320 health. Because a fireball takes them all out, so that's totally okay. Or a wizard can actually two-shot them when they're all clumped up together. Even if you split them, you can stop that one Zappy on the left lane for one elixir, or completely ignore it. Doesn't matter, it's just one Zappy, whatever. Now, with the Royal Recruits though, it's the ability to play three Zappies worth of health on the left lane, and then three Zappies worth of health on the right lane. And get this, they have a shield on top of all of that health. You can't use spells because they have a shield. You can't use big spells to take out both lanes because they're so spread out. You can't even use a tornado because the tornado's not big enough. If you're lucky though, and your opponent doesn't support them, you can take them out with Rascals or even a wizard with skeletons on your side though, for a neutral elixir trade. But let's be real, who's gonna play them by themselves? You can't take them out with spells. You can't take them out with heavy hitters like mini P.E.K.K.A.s. You can't take them out with splashers. The main issue here is they have so much health and no way to address both lanes. They have the health of swarmies, but they're not technically a swarmie. They're a different class of their own. If you ignore two of them, that's around 700 damage. If you ignore three of them, they'll deal over 1700 damage. Put it this way, you can counter 7 elixir P.E.K.K.A. for 6 elixir and counter push the other lane. Ignored, your opponent basically gave up that tower just because they only ignored 3 elixir worth of Royal Recruits, which they probably had to ignore because that P.E.K.K.A. is already so expensive. To summarize, they're easy to use, offer almost no punishment when they're used, they play like 3 elixir cards, they stop virtually everything that's ground-based, and punish the other lane. There is no chain lightning mechanic that can deal with horizontal swarm, so because of this, they're in a new category of their own and are undeserving of the health, offering little counterplay options for you other than to use them yourself as well. So what would I do to fix this? I think I would squish them closer so that players have more choices of placement. This will make them more vulnerable to splash units and would reduce the split pressure power. The health can be tweaked here and there, but personally, I think the main issue is that they create a horizontal line. This creates a new mechanic, and there's no counter mechanic to that in the game currently, so it just completely breaks the game. Let me know in the comments what you guys think about the card. If you guys want to watch more videos, it's going to be on the right side. If you guys want to sub, just hit the button down below. Thanks for watching.